A reverse osmosis. In short, known as RO. कि reverse osmosis त्याचे definition एक छोटसं application आपल्याला बघायचं आहे. आता short form आपण म्हणतोय RO, which is more familiar. कि तुम्ही जे ब्रेजे काही वॉटर प्युरिफायर आपण बघतोय त्यावर ते मेन्शन केलेलं असतं RO, हा रिव्हर्स ऑस्मॉसिस. ती डायग्राम पुन्हा एकदा आपण ड्रॉ करूया. कि सपोज दिस इज अ लार्ज वेसल सेपरेटेड इंटू टू कंपार्टमेंट विथ द हेल्प ऑफ सेमी परमिएबल मेम्ब्रेन. सपोज दिस इज अ सेमी परमिएबल मेम्ब्रेन. टुवर्ड द राइट हैंड साइड there is a solution. For example, it is a sea water. And towards left hand side, there is a pure solvent, that is a pure water. Suppose this compartment contains a pure water. During osmosis, a pure solvent enters into sea water. This is our normal process known as a osmosis. But at higher pressure, this process takes place in a reverse manner. At very high pressure, a flow of solute molecules instead of solvent. खरं तर सॉल्व्हंटचा फ्लो व्हायला पाहिजे. बट ऍट हाय प्रेशर फ्लो ऑफ अ सोल्युट मॉलिक्युल्स इन टू अ प्युअर सॉल्व्हंट टेक्स प्लेस थ्रू दिस अ सेमी परमिएबल मेम्ब्रेन इज कॉल्ड एज अ रिव्हर्स ऑस्मॉसिस. अ रिव्हर्स ऑस्मॉसिस इज नथिंग बट it is the process in which a solute molecules passes into pure solvent through a semi permeable membrane at high pressure is called as a osmosis. Hence the height of pure water goes on increasing and few salts remains toward this side. This reverse osmosis is used for a filtration or a purification of water or to obtain a pure water from a sea water. A reverse osmosis is generally used to get pure water from a salty water, that is a sea water. In Florida, this process is mostly used to obtain a drinking water from a sea water. आतापर्यंत आपण ऑस्मॉसिस म्हणजे काय, त्यानंतर ऑस्मॉटिक प्रेशर, त्यासाठी छोटा एक्सपेरिमेंट रिव्हर्स ऑस्मॉसिस, आणि त्यानंतर आपण बघितलंय की आपण छोटा एक्सपेरिमेंट त्यासाठी जो आपण बघितलाय, त्यानंतर आता आपल्याला बघायचंय की रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन ऑस्मॉटिक प्रेशर एज वेल एज अ कॉन्स्टंट प्रेशर ऑफ अ सोल्यूशन. व्हॉट इज द रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन ऑस्मॉटिक प्रेशर, ऑस्मॉटिक प्रेशर पार्ट एंड अ कॉन्सन्ट्रेशन ऑफ अ सोल्यूशन. Concentration of a solution. This osmotic pressure part is equal to N2 into R into T upon V. Osmotic pressure is equal to N2, where N2 is equal to number of moles of solute particles. R is equal to gas constant, T is equal to temperature, and V is equal to volume of a solution. But we know that the number of moles divided by volume, N2 upon V, that is moles of solute divided by volume, is equal to concentration, that is molarity of a solution. And one more, osmotic pressure power is equal to M into R into V. Osmotic pressure power, concentration of solution in molarity multiplied by gas constant multiplied by absolute temperature. These are a relationship between osmotic pressure and a concentration of a solution. Then a determination of molar mass. Determination of molar mass, that is M2 of a solute from osmotic pressure. As we say earlier, this osmosis and osmotic pressure is most precisely used process to determine the molar mass of a solute. Now, we have a question of pi is equal to N2 RT upon V. If W2 gram of solute is dissolved in V liter of solution having molar mass M2. A simple consideration of that. Kiti amount ghetli apa solute chi? W2 gram of solute dissolved in V liter which having molar mass M2. Hence, this number of moles N2 is equal to the formula maite. The number of moles is nothing but it is the ratio of mass divided by molar mass. Hence, N2 is equal to mass of solute divided by molar mass of a solute. Mass of solute divided by molar mass of solute. Kite mass W2 and molar mass is equal to M2 which is equal to N2. Suppose this is equation number 2 and this is equation number 1. Put these values in equation number 1. Pi is equal to W2 upon M2 into RT divided by V. Hence, molar mass of solute M2 is equal to W2 RT divided by osmotic pressure multiplied by volume of the solution. By using this equation, we can calculate the molar mass of a solute. And I chapter the last units of the colligative properties of electrolytic solutions. The property upon explanation, these are the properties of non-electrolytic solutions. The last short of the concept colligative properties of electrolytic solution. Kya apan definition bagitli? The colligative properties are those properties which depends only upon the number of solute particles present in the solution. The colligative properties are those properties which depends only number of solute particles and independent. Kashavarti independent hai? These are independent on the nature of a solute particle. The solute particles are nature ka hai, yavarti independent hai. These are dependent only upon the number of solute particles. The colligative properties of non-electrolytic solutions and electrolytic solutions are not similar. That is, the colligative properties of electrolytic solutions and non-electrolytic solutions having equimolar concentration, same concentration, are different. जर सॉल्यूशनचं कॉन्सन्ट्रेशन सारखंच असेल नॉन इलेक्ट्रोलिटिक आणि इलेक्ट्रोलिटिक तर प्रॉपर्टी आपल्याला कशा मिळायला पाहिजे होत्या सारख्याच मिळायला पाहिजे होत्या बट दीज प्रॉपर्टीज आर डिफरंट व्हाय दीज प्रॉपर्टीज आर डिफरंट व्हॉट आर द कॉजेस व्हॉट आर द रिझन्स ही वेगवेगळे रिझन्स आपल्याला बघायचे त्यापैकी फर्स्ट रिझन दीज इलेक्ट्रोलिटिक पार्टिकल्स आर electrolytic solutions undergo a dissociation or association. In polar solvent or in aqueous solution, for example, NaCl, sodium chloride plus water will use Na plus aqueous and Cl minus aqueous. That is, one molecule is divided into two ions as number goes on increasing. Colligative property also increases. Such dissociation is not possible in non-electrolytic solutions. And hence, these properties are different though they have same concentration. These colligative properties of electrolytic solutions are greater than non-electrolytic solutions. The colligative properties of electrolytic solutions are greater than non-electrolytic solutions. While the molar mass or molecular weight of electrolytic solutions are lower than non-electrolytic solution as dissociation takes place. The kind of difference is the colligative properties of electrolytic solutions are greater than non-electrolytic solutions while molar mass is lower than non-electrolytic solutions. In this chapter, we have already seen the classification of solutions into various types. That is on the basis of the physical states of solute and solvent. Solutions are classified into 9 types. On the basis of amount of solute present in definite amount of solvent, solutions are classified into 3 types. A saturated, supersaturated, non-saturated solution. A saturated solution, supersaturated solution, and so on. Right? On the basis of this osmotic pressure pi, solutions are classified into 3 types. On the basis of osmotic pressure, solutions are classified into 3 types. The first one, isotonic solution. Second one, hypertonic solution. And last one, hypotonic solution. तीन वेगवेगळ्या टाइप्स आपण बघतोय मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टंट आहे इफ दिस वर्ड आयसो मीन्स सेम टोन मीन्स प्रेशर फिनिश यू कॅन प्रिपेअर अ डेफिनेशन युअरसेल्फ दॅट इज टू आर मोर दॅन टू सोल्युशन्स हॅविंग सेम ऑस्मॉटिक प्रेशर इज कॉल्ड एज अ आयसोटोनिक सोल्युशन टू आर मोर दॅन टू सोल्युशन्स हॅविंग सेम osmotic pressure is called as an isotonic solution. Hyper means high, higher, and tone means a pressure. That is, a solution having higher osmotic pressures than other solution is called as a hypertonic solution. Solution having higher osmotic pressure than other solutions are called as a hypertonic. While last one, hypo means low, a solution having lower osmotic pressure than other solution is known as a hypotonic solution. Take a simple example of Pombogate. The isotonic solution, for example, 0.1 molar urea is isotonic with 0.1 molar sugar solution. Concentration same, qualitative property, hence they can develop same osmotic pressure. The same concentrated solutions are isotonic with each other. Why? 0.2 molar urea solutions are hypertonic with 0.1 molar sugar solution. 0.2 molar urea solution is hypertonic than 0.1 molar same urea solution. In reverse manner, 0.1 molar sugar solution is hypotonic than 0.2 molar sugar solution. Okay? Iso means same, hyper means excess and hyper means low. A thin over laksha kevde, that's a great definition to be prepared for shukra. It the second chapter of the solutions, the madla sagla theoretical terms of an experimental. You have also worked with the Leibniz of solution, then classification of solution. Then, effect of various factors on the solubility or qualitative property, the definitions, explanation, and determination of molar masses of solute with the help of these qualitative properties, Raoult's law for volatile as well as a non-volatile solute. Okay? Thank you. Stop here.